Here's my full and completely honest review of the Fifine H8 headphones. These are an excellent pair of headphones for producing, listening to music, video editing, whatever your use is, especially for the price. And these are only $37, which for the sound quality, the build, and what you get is excellent. Now, getting into the review, and I'm going to be very honest about the pros and the cons, as I am in all my videos. First off, what you get the headphones, of course. Let me just show you like this. So it comes like that. So as you can see, great build. They feel pretty soft as well. In addition, there is some slight noise canceling effects when it comes to the headphones as well. It's not like Bose that has it built into it, but just by putting these over my ears, it does help cancel the background sound, background noise around in my environment, which helps a lot. Especially because you don't want to be blasting music, especially with ear damage being a real thing. In addition, you get two cords, and I don't know if I'm the only musician that's like this or person that's like this. I get just as excited for new cords as I do for the actual headphones. First off, we have an 1/8 inch to a 1/4 inch cord right here. I will say this as well. This does not screw off. On some 1/4 inch to 1/8 inch cords, this is actually like a part that's a 1/4 inch to 1/8 inch converter. This is actually just a straight 1/4 inch, which is actually kind of nice. So have that right here, which is typically what I use in case you're curious. When I do make music with headphones, I connect my headphones into the Focusrite Solo Compact. I find the sound quality is just significantly better. So I connect the Focusrite Solo Compact via USB to my computer, and then plug the headphones in straight 1/4 inch into that. And then also comes with an 1/8 inch to 1/8 inch. So if anything, for most people, I feel like, unless you're using these headphones just to listen to music, this makes the most sense for most devices, like say your smartphone, besides an iPhone. You also, of course, you need the attachment or anything else. And then let's say if you're making music, like say you're DJing, for example, this is gonna be probably your cord of choice. And the great thing is you get both. Now, when it comes to the sound, let's be honest, you're getting headphones, not just for the feel, the look, the cores it comes with. It's all about the sound. In terms of the frequencies, these go from 20 hertz to 20 K hertz. So it's a pretty huge distance, and the sound quality, especially given the price on these headphones, is excellent. It does have a very flat feel, meaning there's a very flat EQ spectrum when it comes to low, mid, and high. On some headphones, they will purposely have the bass be a bit higher or something like that. Especially when it comes to making music, you do not want that. As you can imagine, if you get a pair of headphones that the bass is naturally a bit higher and you're making music, you might think, oh wow, the bass is super loud. So you might make your bass quieter or less in the mix. And then when you actually play it out live, you're like, wow, the bass actually isn't good at all. And that's of course because the headphones naturally boost the bass. So in this case, you have a very flat spectrum, very flat, low, mid, and high, which is exactly what you want. There's not a boost in either one. Now, of course, going to the cons. No product is ever perfect, and I like to be very transparent on the good and the bad parts. There's only two things I'm gonna say when it comes to negatives about these. One is the build. I will say, I mean, keep in mind, they are $37. So the build does not feel as high quality compared to other headphones that are hundreds of dollars, but of course, that makes sense, right? If you're gonna buy a pair of headphones that are hundreds of dollars, of course the build is gonna feel a lot better. So that's the first thing I will say when it comes to these, but it's not really a big issue. In my opinion, I don't really care. To me, it's all about the sound. So let's talk about that in terms of the cons. I did compare these to the Audio-Technica ATH-M50X headphones. Those are very well-known headphones, especially when it comes to music production. And comparing the sounds, it was surprising how good this compared to the Audio-Technica ATH-M50X headphones. Of course, the ATH-M50X headphones had a better sound than these, and that makes sense. I also will say, especially in the mid-range, I noticed the sound was significantly better with the Audio-Technicas versus these. However, and I just checked on Amazon, right now, at least at the exact time of this video, the Audio-Technica ATH-M50X headphones are $170 versus $37. So these are 5 times cheaper than the Audio-Technicas. For these being 5 times cheaper, the sound quality is still excellent. I gotta say, for a pair of $37 headphones, these are an excellent value for what you get, the quality, and of course, the most important part, the sound.